Hare Krishna. Respect the dark within you to keep it within you. Suppose we have a serious enemy. Now that enemy is not to be taken lightly. And that enemy needs to be treated with respect. Not respect in the sense of positive regard, in the sense the way we might give to our guru or give to worshipful elders. But still, it needs to be that enemy needs to be respected so that we stay guarded. And sometimes that enemy helps us to become more alert, more skilled, and more sharp. So in that sense, the enemy may work for our good, although the enemy has no intention to work for our good. And the enemy will work for our good only when we respect that enemy and take the threat of the enemy seriously. So all of us have a dark side within us. And the darkness can be selfishness, lust, anger, greed, envy. And this dark, which is there within us, it can pop up at any time. So the darkness within us needs to be respected. Respected in the sense that we need to recognize that it can pop up any time and it can overcome us. And if you're not careful, it may devour us. It may delude and degrade us. So to prevent that, what do we need to do? We need to actually respect it. Respect it, not so that we imitate it, but respect it so that we guard ourselves against it. The Bhagavad-Gita offers, Bhagavad-Gita tells that most of our impressions, including many of our dark impressions, or most of our impressions are dark impressions, are stored in our mind. And thus the mind often acts like our enemy. So the darkness within us is stored in our mind. And we need to treat it carefully. We need to treat it with respect. And this respectful dealing is what the Bhagavad-Gita recommends when it says in 6.5, Uddhared Atmanatmanam, Natmanam avasadayet, Atmaiva yatmano bandhur, Atmaiva ripuratmanaha. It says that elevate yourself with yourself. Don't degrade yourself with the self. Because the self is the enemy of the self, and the self is also the enemy of the self is also the friend of the self. That means there is dark within us and there is the bright within us. So now the dark within needs to be kept within so that it doesn't come out and make us do dark things. Of course, best would be that we remove the dark, we purge the darkness from within us by becoming purified, by becoming cleansed internally. Now that can happen when we apply ourselves to spiritual processes of purification such as Bhakti Yoga. But during that process, while we are getting purified, we need to respectfully deal with the dark within us, knowing that it can darken our life at any moment. So by staying connected with the supreme light of Krishna and letting that light illumine us constantly, externally and internally, we can keep the dark within and gradually remove it from within. Instead of letting it stay within and by our carelessness come out and consume our whole life with the darkness. Thank you. Hare Krishna.